Now we're going to show you how to calibrate the internal 3D LUT of the TVLogic XVM-245W Grade 1 broadcast monitor. We're going to be using the Color Cube workflow, the SpectraCal C6 meter, and SpectraCal's Virtual Forge pattern generator. I have the workflow open, Color Cube 3D LUT, and I already have my meter connected. My meter's already connected, but I need to select the RGB LED mode for the meter, because this is an RGB LED backlit display. We're going to search for our source, which is Virtual Forge. We're going to select SpectraCal as the manufacturer, Virtual Forge. Your machine should automatically come up here, but if it doesn't, hit search. I'm going to select it, hit connect. Since this is an LCD display, I'm going to use full screen patterns. We're going to go to find 3D LUT device, select TVLogic, and select your COM port that your serial adapter is connected to, in this case, COM4. Hit connect. This does take a little while because it's over serial. Don't be alarmed if it seems like it's taking a little while. Now that we're connected, our LUT memory, we're going to select user, and we have the same one already selected in the display itself. Once you click it, it will take a few moments to switch to that LUT memory. Okay, now that we have selected the user 3D LUT memory, we're going to go to next and select our calibration standard. We're going to use video levels or SMPTE levels. We're going to use BT1886 as our EOTF or gamma, and HD Rec 709 and D65 as our white point and color space. Now we'll do the pre-calibration measurement to see where it is. This really doesn't apply. We're not going to see what it was out of the factory, because once you're in that user LUT mode, it's essentially in a native gamut mode. It's not applying any LUT. So if you wanted to see what your monitor was really doing before you created the LUT, you would select one of the presets and measure this, and then you could switch to the user LUT to see what it's doing in its native mode. Before I take the pre-calibration measurements, I'm going to ensure that our pattern delay is correct by running the pattern delay optimizer. Click the center tab, which is our pattern generator, and go down to our optimize button and run the optimize procedure. It's all automated. It essentially makes sure that when CalMAN goes to take a read, the pattern is fully rendered on the screen. There is some latency in the system, and we never know quite what that latency is unless we actually measure it. And you also don't want it to be too long and have too much delay, or else you're just wasting time, especially when you're making a 3D LUT. It adds a lot of time when you're taking several thousand readings. Now we will run our pre-calibration capture.
This part is going to take just a minute or two, so we'll come back once it's complete.
Now we're going to go to our display performance analysis. Normally, you would want to make all these green. On this display, when you create a 3D LUT for it, it goes into its native mode, which is applying nothing. No correction, no white balance controls or anything like that. It just is what it is, and then all the calibration happens with the 3D LUT. As noted in our quick start guide, you can't do the RGB gains and offsets in this display if you're going to do a 3D LUT. Because of the way that they're in the video path, they'll actually make the LUT not work properly. So you want to leave those as a preset, like 6500 or one of those. You don't want to modify those controls, put it into a custom mode or anything like that. Since we can't actually optimize the display, we're just going to go to the Calibrate Cube LUT part. And since this display does not have a 1D LUT, we can skip over this step. Now we're at the Calibrate Cube LUT page. Since this is a grade 1 display that will probably be used for color grading, we're going to run an IRP LUT just to make sure it gets that extra little bit of accuracy. We'll go to our AutoCal. I'm going to switch this to IR profile, point based. I'm going to do 2000. Now I've already ran the pattern delay optimizer. And that's where the pattern delay optimizer, if you don't run it, you won't get an accurate estimate of how long the actual calibration is going to take. So you want to make sure you do that. And now I hit OK and let it run. Now we're going to let CalMAN do its thing, and we'll be back after we create the LUT. Now that our 3D LUT is complete, it's loading it into the TVLogic now, and it does have this thing where It wants you to power cycle the monitor, which is essentially turn it on and turn it off on the front panel button, not the like big switch in the back. And then after it's back on, hit the OK button. And now it will be complete. Go to next and run our verification. So now we're going to do a read series here. One thing to note that we didn't show is on the TVLogic monitor, it can take between 8 and 12 minutes to load the LUT because it's doing it over serial. So don't be alarmed if it takes a long time.
And this is going to take just a few dozen readings of color points, so we'll come back in a minute or two when all the data is collected.
Now that our measurements are complete, we have a grayscale delta E average of 1.1 and a color checker delta E average of 0.6. If you want to calibrate a different color space besides Rec 709, the TVLogic, each of its color space settings, not only the user one, but like it's Rec 709 or DCI P3, you can write over those with your own LUTs. If you wanted to, you can make the Rec 709 preset Rec 709 and the DCI one, write your own DCI P3 LUT over the top. You're not just limited to the user LUT. You can write over the built-in color spaces. Those are their own 3D LUTs.